Hello. Assignment 13, part 3. This is going to be our third set of data information, and we're going to use the IRIS data set that we had previously looked at in another assignment. In order to look at that information, we have IRIS Setosa, Virginica, Vericolor, and Versicolor. I think there's only three of them. And the scatter plot from those, there is nothing. So let's just remove that. We're actually going to be looking at the petal information. So if the petal is long or wide, and the stem, if it's long, or the width of the stem as well. We're going to be using the k-means. This is what this one was previously meant for. There are 8 different categories. However, we're going to stick with the 2. That is one that it was. 2 is the silhouette score, the best silhouette score for this set of data points. So I think that that is a good low number that we can look at. Let's see. There we go. We have two data sections there. Let's look at the different scatter plots. So this is the two sections. We have petal length and sepal width. That one looked pretty good. Here we go. Petal length and a sepal length and the different clusters. So that's really nice. Let's stick with that one. Something I didn't talk about before. Here we can see the different clusters. It looks almost like there are 3 different clusters total. But it is categorizing these two together in that two. Let's see if we can change our k-means. We'll fix it on 3. We'll make it say 3 and see what it comes up with then. Let's see, and do 4. And do 5. And we'll change this to the cluster silhouettes. All right. That is 3, or that's 5. So we have 2 different colors here in the bottom. We have a yellow and a green in this section here, which is the different color 6. So here we go. If we pushed it to do 3, it pretty much fixates the 3 different irises that we have in this information. However, the 2 irises are in 1 cluster. So this is interesting because k-means doesn't do a very good job of naturally analyzing a line. It does a lot better on circular clusters. That was presented in some of our information when we were learning about this topic. I would say because of the 3 flowers, this makes more sense because there is 2 separate clusters for that. However, the information does suggest to have 2, which makes sense if you're looking at this data. This looks like 1 cluster and that looks like 1 cluster. So let's fix this information on 3 clusters because it talks about the petals and the 3 different varieties of iris flowers that we are looking at in the data. And we will look at this again in assignment 14. The information we need from here is going to be in here. So let's select all. Well, we could do 2 things. Let's edit that to there. And we will remove that. So here we have the same information. We have the 3... 2, 1. Perfect. 3. That is fine. We have the data from the k-means, and we are going to be using the fixed three categories in the scatter plot that we see here. From this data, we have this line here, the cluster and the silhouette. I want this data for our next section, or assignment 14, using the same data. So I'm going to save this data. And in order to save it, we have to go up here in this corner, select everything, very similar to an Excel file. And then when that is selected, we can save the data. Let's save as, and we're going to do information technology is fine. And we are going to do, let's do number 14, IRIS, because that's what we need for our part. Perfect. So we will look at that in very shortly. So we did go with 3 on this one. Our scatter plot looks just like that. We did use one of the informative projections. The different clusters are selected, and here are the iris. So I think we could change the silhouettes a little bit, because some of these are wrong, because this section here should be the other type of iris. As you can see, there's the red, and this should be a different section. But looking at the clusters, I like that there are 3 clusters instead of just the 2. So we'll look at that more in depth on our map later. Thank you for watching, and we will continue on in assignment 14.